we just talk? Can we just talk?
So today we're talking to Derek, licensed marriage and family therapist. Derek, you've been in the industry for about 7 years and you have a YouTube channel called The Situational Therapist. We're going to talk about relationships and communication.
Okay.
So when you're trying to go and buy or sell a house, you have a lot of decisions. And one thing you see and you hear a lot about in the real estate industry is about couples that start going down this path to buy a house, and somewhere along the way, they break up. So what would you say, so if there's a couple or somebody that's in a relationship that is looking to potentially go buy or sell a house right now, but they haven't started the process yet, do you have any like recommendations or things that you would suggest that they do to make sure that they're having clear conversation?
Absolutely. It depends on the type. It depends on the type of couple that we're talking about, right? If we're talking about a couple that's having the normal communication issues that most couples have, right? If it's just day to day, like, you know what, living and existing with each other sometimes can be difficult. I would say set aside time to talk about the entirety of what the experience means to you. Don't even worry about like dollars and cents and all that stuff yet. That will come. You can always go to someone who is an expert to give you expert knowledge on that. I think the most important thing for a couple, what does it mean to you for us to buy a house together? Figure that out, and then you will have the communication will flow. But the problem is that couples aren't asking the right questions. That's the question that needs to be asked, and everything else will come from that.
Yeah. And I would also add, as an agent, when we're doing, like, for example, a buyer consultation, one of the things that we will ask is like, where are you looking to buy? Like, what do you want in a house? And we'll kind of then ask, what are the 5 must-haves? And then a lot of agents will ask, why are those must-haves? And I think it's beneficial. It sounds like what you're saying, it's beneficial right to like have those conversations before you're in a room with somebody that's a third party, right?
Right. We call it the miracle question, but it's enough because it just gets you to really get to it. And you can't, there's no reason to fight. There's no reason to argue over what something means to someone. That's their subjective experience. You don't have to argue over that. And you can see where those differences in meanings, where they are, and then you can apply that to the problem that you're having.
Can you remind us what the question was again, one more time?
Absolutely. The question is, what does buying a house, whatever part of the process that you're in, overall though, what does buying a house mean to you? What does this mean for our relationship? What does this mean for how you see us? What do you think this means for the future? What are we going to do after we buy the house? Like, what do you think this is setting up? How do you see this going? What's playing in your mind? And I think once you understand that, then you can see why people make the decisions that they make. That's what's scary, because that conversation can open up a lot of stuff. Caveat, it will open up a lot of things.
Yeah, but maybe those are the things that need to be talked about.
Absolutely.
Need to be opened up.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, I think that's a good way of looking at it. Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Derek. And if somebody wanted to reach you, how could they do that?
They can reach me at Derek@thesituationaltherapist.com.
Great. You have a great day.
You too. Thank you.